Can people become better friends over the course of just a few minutes? Well, today we're gonna find out. My name is Stian, and this is 36 Questions. Joining me is my co-star in Home for Christmas, Felix Sandman.
What is up, guys? What is up?
And the crowd goes wild. Woo! 36 Questions to Fall in Love is a famed little experiment from the psychologist Arthur Aron. And it's supposed to provoke deep thought from your date. Mm-hmm. You're my date.
We're on a date right now.
We're on a date. It's supposed to let me know like why you are the way you are and give me some info. Mm-hmm. And we're topping it off with a good old 4 minute unbroken eye contact at the end.
Oh, yeah. Great.
Just to top it off.
Yes.
So,
love these kind of dates.
Let's fall in love.
Yes, please.
Let's do it. You ready?
I'm ready.
Given the choice of anyone in the world, who would you want as a dinner guest?
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh, wow. Why?
Because I would want to talk about environment and like, because he's he talks about it a lot and he is doing a lot of stuff for the environment. So I want to talk about that. Mm-hmm. And I'm also the biggest fan ever. So I want to ask him about every scene in Wolf of Wall Street and Inception.
Yeah.
And
like, yeah. So one part environment, one part fanboy.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, right. Before making a phone call, do you ever rehearse what you're going to say?
Yes.
Do you?
Yes.
Why?
It's always when I call like hospitals and like the dentist or like book an appointment. Cause I don't know that like that's the only like moment I'm like nervous and like feeling like pressure.
The dentist?
Yeah, cause like yeah, like calling them because I just want to sound like an adult. I just want to sound like. Like,
this is Felix.
Yeah, like an appointment. Like,
got a teeth problem.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, you know?
Okay.
Yes, I do that. I do that.
What would constitute a perfect day for Felix?
I would say a perfect day would be 7 a.m. in the morning.
All right.
On set for a Netflix production.
Selling it.
Shooting that shit.
He's selling it.
And then at maybe 5 p.m. I go to a big ass arena venue, play a show, just do that, sing for thousands and thousands of people. And then I go home to my girlfriend and watch a kick-ass movie.
Boom. That sounds pretty perfect.
Yep.
And could happen.
Could happen.
And could happen. Yeah.
High hopes though.
When did you last sing to yourself? Like when did you sing to somebody else not in a show? Ever sing for your girl?
Yeah. Many times. I'd say the last time was like, last week home.
Wow.
With my girlfriend. We watched High School Musical.
And
no, so I did the, because I was so in love with Zac Efron when I was a kid. Like he was my Justin Bieber. Like,
yeah, he was
I
awesome.
I want to be Zac Efron. I want to be Troy though. I wanted to be his character. And so yeah, so I sang for my girlfriend and bet on it, like that. And danced around.
Love that movie.
Yeah.
If you could wake up tomorrow having gained one quality or ability, what would it be?
Flying? Yeah.
All right, why?
Cause that's freedom. Imagine that shit being like Iron Man.
Yeah, but okay, take today. It's like -7 outside. Like flying would be,
but you have good jackets in Norway, right?
Yeah,
yeah. You just put on a good jacket.
You see the solutions. I only see the problems. Yeah, that's good. All right. If a crystal ball could tell you the truth about yourself, your life, the future, or anything else, what would you want to know?
I kind of like I'm a believer in faith. Mm. So I don't really want to mess with my future. I would ask the ball, will I ever buy a Lamborghini?
Yeah. Of all the things.
Yeah, but I hate these because I don't want to think about future.
No? All right, is there something that you've dreamt of doing for a long time? And if it is, why haven't you done it?
I've dreamt about jumping out of an airplane.
Parachuting?
Yeah. Yeah, with a parachute.
Yeah, all right.
But I haven't done that yet.
I've tried it.
Have you tried it?
Insane.
It's insane, right?
It is insane.
Would you do it again?
No.
What, really?
No.
Like when my feet hit the ground, I was like,
I'm done.
I'm alive. I did it. Bought the t-shirt.
So it was just like a gamble. Like next time I might die.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah. Like I can check it off my bucket list. Uh-huh. I'm out of here.
Wow. Okay.
What is your most treasured memory?
That's a dear memory. The when we played the same venue that Justin Bieber sold out. We sold out that venue. That was a big moment, big milestone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. This one is maybe easier or harder.
Okay.
What's your most terrible memory?
A terrible memory would be when my ex broke up with me.
Yeah.
Yeah, that time was the worst I've ever felt.
That sounds terrible.
Laying on the floor and crying.
Yeah,
you know,
all that stuff.
Mom's trying to lift me up. I just want to stay on the floor.
Yeah, you were down.
Know? Yeah, that's a terrible memory.
If you were going to become a close friend with me, please share what would be important for me to know.
I am really bad at answering calls and texts.
Why?
So don't take it personal when I don't answer your texts. Because I love you.
But I will.
You will, but you will have to learn, and I will have to learn too. Because that's how good relationships work, you know?
All right. Tell me something that you like about me already.
Oh, which I think is really important. I feel like you want to be nice to people around you, and I think that's an important quality, that like it comes naturally for you to be nice to people you work with.
Thank you. That is actually the best compliment you can give me, so thank you.
Well, thanks for thanking me.
All right, the last one. And this question leads directly into 4 minutes of unbroken eye contact.
Okay.
So share a personal problem with me and ask me for advice on how I would handle it.
Okay.
Unbroken eye contact.
Stian.
Yeah.
No, shit, I failed.
Is this more awkward than the sex scene?
Yes.
Is it?
Yes.
Why?
That's not my problem here. I'm gonna ask you.
Are you gonna ask me?
I'm gonna ask you for advice.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have a big problem with staying in touch with people.
Yeah.
What do you think is?
You can look into your soul.
What do you think is the solution? What's your advice? How would you handle it?
Just fix it. Like the amount of effort it takes to send a text is so small, and the reward is so big.
The thing is,
yeah, stay in touch with me.
The thing is, I feel sometimes it's hard to always be connected because we live in an age, digital age, where we're. Why is this so hard? I keep failing.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Okay.
Stay here.
Yeah, yeah. It stresses me out to always. Someone can always reach me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But you have to just pick and choose.
Mm-hmm.
Like the ones that really matter, always answer.
Mm-hmm.
And the ones that you can answer tomorrow and whatever, don't do it.
Okay.
Before you go on stage, just going on stage, love ya, bye. And she's like, he's thinking of me right before he goes on stage.
Great idea.
Yeah. All right.
That's what I'm gonna do with you. I'm gonna send you a text.
Should we end the eye contact?
Hey, babe, I'm going to bed.
See ya.
See ya. Wow, that was hard.
Ah, that was intense. God. That was intense.
And I kept looking away all the time, like that.
Yeah.
It's just like a reaction. Wow.
Thank you. I'm in love.
I'm in love too. Thanks for watching, guys.
Thank you.